school, just a little bit ago, we were talking about the people of God wandering in the desert, in the wilderness. Can you imagine what it was like for those people of Israel who were actually born in the wandering wilderness? Some of them were born there. What was it like for them when they finally entered the promised land? What were those first days like? Those first nights of sleep when they were settled in a safe place? They'd actually seen their parents, a whole generation, die as refugees. But they came in and they put down their tents, literally, in a fertile land where they would live for over 500 years. God bestowed on them a good land and hedged them in with God's love. Some of us, somewhere in our family tree, might have people who came to this country in condition not so different than those Israelites. My ancestors, a good portion of them, happened to be Irish. And when I think of them, I think of people not that different than the Israelites coming into the Promised Land in the mid-1800s. The Irish came from a land where a million people died. They came from a land where their main source of food, the potato, suddenly got terrible disease that spread throughout the whole island. And 500,000 were evicted out of their homes and off their farms. And I can imagine that when they made the crossing in whatever kind of ship they could cling on board to, often with cattle or animals or freight, what was it like when they finally got planted in a place with a good night's sleep, with home and peace and food for their children, when they found themselves hedged in by the love of God? What about the people in your lives? Are there stories like that back in your family tree? Maybe a little bit different. And we all have stories ourselves. When I think of those people, the main emotion I think of that I can imagine for them is gratitude. Don't you think they were just bursting with thankfulness? That their whole lives had to be sort of empowered by thanksgiving? People I've known who've undergone and endured suffering and struggle are often really clear about grace. It seems to me that those people who go through things, they're clear about the stuff that they do, and they're really clear about God's gifts to them. About sheer gift in their lives. I remember a story, and I think I may have shared it in a sermon before. Maybe it had such a big impact on me. Simple story, really. I was traveling from Belgium to England, and my boat broke down going across the channel, and it went really slowly. Really slowly. It took us hours to get from Belgium to the port of England. And so I arrived in London in the middle of the night and got on the underground to get to my train station. And it's the only time I ever got lost on the London Underground. I suddenly, deep there down in the caverns under London, and I find myself out in Clapham. And that's not where I need to be at all, you know? And I'm like, oh! So finally I get myself righted and I get to Paddington Station. Thank God, in time for the last train. It's probably like 1 in the morning, 2 in the morning. But of course, the last train is by no means the express, you know? This is not the commuter train, and it stops at every town, village, along the way to the West Country. And I'm getting a strep throat, right? Somewhere on the voyage, I'm starting to get this strep throat. It's just raging. Finally, I get to Exeter at about 3 in the morning, 4 in the morning. And of course, that's not when the taxis really, you know, are waiting for people. So there's no taxis there. Have to call one, get to my rooming house. Oh, praise the Lord. I open the door, go up the stairs, go to my bedroom, and there's another student in my bed. Well, I had this very loving Christian landlady who heard me, you know, came out, gathered me up, got me a hot drink and honey, and got me a place on the sofa. And I don't think that I'd ever seen a safe haven before. Suddenly, I was so grateful for that house. It was a fairly modest house. So grateful for a bed, for a place of warmth. And after that, I kind of lived that out differently. I saw her as I should have always seen her, right? I started buying her gifts, you know? Little flowers and things like that, and I started taking better care of that place in which I lived. Now, you probably have a story like that. Maybe you were in the hospital, something far worse than my little tale. It kept you away from home or from your family, or you were in the service. Maybe you were simply camping and got lost in the middle of the wilderness. And do you remember what it was like? You got back in and you were safe and warm. We are, each of us, hedged in by God's love every day. We live in safety and peace. Today's lessons from Isaiah and from the Gospel picture this reality for us. They picture our lives as a carefully tended vineyard that God loves, that God takes the rocks out, God builds a wall around, hedges us in safety. And the fruit that's supposed to come is simply that fruit I've talked about. Gratitude. Gratefulness. Every day of our lives should be filled with the gratitude for the beautiful life that God gives us. That is the fruit talked about throughout Scripture. It's called many words. Righteousness is one, but it simply means we love God because God loves us and cares for us. And we are to love others because that love he pours into our lives is too much. Really, it can overflow. We should see what we're given. And like I suddenly saw my landlady, we should be able to see one another and say, you are part of the blessing. That is the fruit, righteousness and justice that God wants from us. But you know what? There is a huge problem in all of this. How long did I stay seeing that house properly? How long did I see my landlady properly? 3 days, you know? Maybe a week, maybe 2 weeks. When you got into safety, how long did that clarity of vision last? It seems that as human beings and as nations, we get amnesia. Suddenly, our great gratitude to God becomes taking things for granted, taking God for granted. We lose sight of the truth that it is God's love alone which hedges us in and keeps us safe. The Israelites whom Isaiah was speaking to were at a place perhaps of forgetting. You know, it was 500 years, right? Since they came out of the wilderness in the desert. 500 years is a long time. And think, you know, it was those mountains that surrounded Jerusalem that nobody really was able to attack them over it. Now, oh, they kind of forgot God. The mountains were keeping them safe. Or they were so special as God's chosen people that nobody would ever harm them. But they sort of forgot about God himself. It was just how great they were. In America, at times, the oceans have been what we thought hedged us in. We didn't have to worry about those wars in Europe, right? World War I and World War II for a while. We were hedged in by the Atlantic and the Pacific. Or I remember learning as a girl about 13 about a sort of hedge of military strength that we have. Do you remember learning about the ballistic missiles and the anti-ballistic missiles? I was like, what a vision, my goodness. We can send bombs halfway across the country, I mean the world. And then if they send them to us, we have these other ones that shoot up there, right? Can knock those other ones down, destroy them, protect us. We can start to put our trust in that military might. Or to put our trust in the fact that we are the wealthiest country in the world. And that nothing is more powerful, nothing can keep us more safe than that money, than that wealth. When we lose our clarity about God's grace, we lose our gratitude. It wanes. As we start to take things for granted or to think that we caused them, then our fruit goes bad. You know when you go to the grocery store and you get grapes? I think the reason they still have those little holes in the plastic, right? You've got to taste them. That's what Isaiah's talking about. You know what I mean? I'm going to be really upset when they're finally really in bags. One grape can look beautiful and taste terrible, right? And it's interesting, the Hebrew here, the grapes are wild in some translations, or rotten, or sour. God's done everything, but if we don't have gratitude, we're sour grapes. I think that it's hard to get around that today's lessons do have some judgment in them. If we take God's love and care for granted, and the prophet Isaiah says to us, as he said to the people, I will remove the hedge. And after 500 years, the Assyrians and the Babylonians came in. They did invade Israel and took Jerusalem. But God has sent us God's Son, Jesus, I think for a special reason, to keep us from amnesia. When we come here and remember his death and his rising, we're called again to thankfulness, to remember that there's nothing that can keep us safe. There is no hedge for us as people, or for us as a nation, than the love of God. This week and the weeks ahead, may we do all that we do out of gratefulness. And may we pray for the leaders of our nation at this time and for the nations of the world, that they will make their decisions trusting in the God who keeps us safe, and in righteousness and justice out of that thankfulness.